I've come to the conclusion that Google Sheets is the best spreadsheet tool out there. And for me to say is big, very big. I have a course on Excel. I have a TikTok account with 100,000 followers that blew up because of Excel. But over the past while, Excel just hasn't been adapting as technology changes. So let's talk about that. So generally, when you create an important spreadsheet, you would want to share it. Now, in the old way of working, you would have had the original file and you would have shared it to other members via a shared folder or even emailed it. Now, when Google Sheets came along, it really helped with people working together. And Sheets have many different ways that you can work together. There's asynchronous editing. So maybe you're working on something and you have a question. You can use a comment feature to alert people to questions and even assign tasks. And those people, once they receive the tasks, can even mark them as complete. They also get an email as soon as something is assigned to them. Now with Sheets, this is all free. With Excel, we know that collaborating on desktop isn't possible, but Microsoft Excel has an online version called Excel Online. And on Excel Online, mentioning and tagging people is possible, but, and this is a big but, mentioning does not work on guests or external accounts. On Excel, you can only mention and tag people if everyone is on a Microsoft 365 account, which is a paid account, which also costs a fortune. But collaboration on Google Sheets, it doesn't end there. Google Sheets has this neat feature called Smart Chips. This enables you to have quick information at your fingertips, such as linking the person responsible for a specific task, or you can even link a file to a specific role or cell, which is awesome. Can Google Sheets handle big data? Yes, it can. And it does it the right way. So people use Excel desktop a lot because it does handle a large amount of data. So with Excel Online itself, you can't handle big data sets. I think it starts getting slow around 50,000 to 100,000 rows, depending on your table. With Excel desktop, you can handle up to 1 million rows. But then the question is, should you handle that much data on your local computer? Because when you get to 1 million rows, your Excel workbook is going to lag. It's going to be slow. It will possibly just stop responding and you will lose all your work. This is where Google was quite smart here when they created Google Sheets. They found a way to seamlessly link Google Sheets to their cloud database, Google BigQuery, and it is great. Once your data is inserted into BigQuery, your cloud database, you're actually ready to import it to Google Sheets. All you need to do is click data, go to data connectors, connect to BigQuery, select your project, select your dataset, and select your table. Here I have 207 million rows here, and I can create charts, I can create pivot tables, I can create advanced calculation, etc., all on my browser. And if the data updates, I just need to click refresh. And the good thing here is that because it's online, your Google Sheet is always auto-saving. And Google Sheets itself is not housing your data, BigQuery is. And BigQuery is a database that is made to house data. Now, sometimes you want to connect to external data, such as being able to pull in stock market information. Something like the Google Finance formula is so useful. It actually helps you pull data directly from Google Finance. So here I can input a formula to give me stock data for Apple between January 2023 and May 2023. And I get an updated table with the results. Now, Excel does have something similar. So if you want to get stock data, you can use the formula stock history on Excel. However, that formula is available for only Microsoft 365 accounts, the paid version of Excel. So if you try it on a free account, this is what you'd see. Now, I do find it a bit weird that Excel has these limitations at such a granular level, where certain formulas can only be used if you are a paying member. At the end of the day, we know that Excel has a plethora of amazing and really advanced functions, which are great, but most people don't need them and won't even use them. It also seems like Microsoft is using any opportunity to get you to buy one of their products by limiting their features, which just isn't a nice look. And the fact that Google Sheets probably has 99% of Excel features, and it's free, and it's online, makes all the difference. It's just a clear winner in most cases.